You're watching 4029, home of the Superior Automotive Group Friday Frenzy High School Football Preview.
Welcome back to this special. I've said it before, and I'll say it again. I am so excited to cover high school sports in this area and, of course, cover some football. And that brings us to our next segment. It's called the Roundtable segment because we've got sort of a roundtable. I brought John back because, of course, I had to, right?
Right.
They made me. But time to bring in our experts. We're joined now by Grant Merrill and Nate Olson of Vype magazine. And you guys, this must be like Christmas for you.
Absolutely. It's Christmas, birthdays all rolled into one. And now that we've got a whole 191-page publication devoted to football, this is what it all comes down to. There's nothing that brings communities in this area together like high school sports and what their kids are doing. And, you know, we just feel very lucky that we've been able to take over Vype magazine and be a part of this.
Well, let's talk some football. John, you started questions.
Well, you know, I think about Bentonville, and obviously they seem to be once again the favorite to win in Class 7A. Barry Lunny, it seems like no matter where he's been, whether it's at Bentonville, whether he's at Southside, that his programs always seem to make it to the top of their classification. Why is that?
He understands how to delegate. You know, last year he had three major tragedies in his life. Three people died in his life that he cared about. Was able to right that ship with right-hand man that he has on his staff, including his son, Barry Jr. And you saw last year how great a coach he is, because that was the worst year for him personally, but the best year for him professionally.
Staying with Class 7A ever since that formation in 2006, not only has the 7A West team won every single year, but we have yet to see a 7A Central team in the finals. Why is there such an imbalance between the West and the Central?
We eat better up here. I mean,
you got a lot of talent to choose from there at a lot of these programs here. And I think just more population and then good coaching. I think also the investment that some of these programs have made in staffs. The staffs are bigger here. Also, junior varsity, sophomore, and freshman teams just seem to be a little bit more organized and a little bit more coaching involved as far as staffs. That's giving them a little bit of a leg up.
We talked about Shiloh Christian earlier in the program. They've got a guy in Kyle Frazier that they're going to have to replace, plus a whole bunch of other guys that they went on to play at some pretty big schools. How are they going to replace those guys, in particular Kyle, and hopefully continue their success?
Well, first of all, you know, Shiloh's always had the target on their back. And you take a look at what Shiloh's been able to do year in and year out. Of course, we still got them ranked number one in our Class 4A preview. And, you know, it seems like every time that they lose, they're able to replenish.
Shiloh wins at every level, at junior high and middle school. So those kids know what it takes. They're going to be green and experienced. Look for the first couple of weeks, maybe a little bit of growing pains there. Once they get into league play, I think they're going to show their form. And by the playoff time, they could be a team that, with that experience of some of those younger kids playing, they could have a chance to make a deep run again.
Right. It also seems like not just the fact that Shiloh is winning, but that they're winning by so much that maybe you run into one team a year like a Pulaski Academy that can actually compete with them. Is there another team out there like that this year, or maybe several that can compete for the 4A title?
Well, Pulaski Academy, I think, is going to be this year's Shiloh Christian. They are loaded. Lots of Division I talent on that team. They're ranked 87th in America by one poll. So they're going to be very good, and if they play Shiloh again, they're going to be much more experienced, maybe a little bit more athletic.
The Magazine Rattlers. I mean, first of all, a great nickname, great story. They used to get stomped upon every Friday night, but have really turned their program around.
I think that's one of the best stories, not only in Arkansas, but in the country. Last year, the run that they went on, and you do it with this team that is so multicultural. You've got the Hmong people that have migrated there. You've got white kids. You've got a girl on the team, Lorraine Doherty, playing with her brother. I mean, it's just a great story. You could almost make a Disney movie out of that, coming from where, you know, from where they came from. I mean, it was, and you've only got two coaches on that staff. They've done a great job. When they won that state championship last year, you are accustomed to seeing very emotional celebrations, but there wasn't a dry eye down there. Kids, coaches, all crying. I mean, you just saw how much blood, sweat, and tears they put into making that run, and it was great to see it.
And before we wrap it up, I know my favorite part of high school football Friday nights is just the passion that you see from not only the kids, but the band and the cheerleaders, and especially when the whole town comes to the games. That's awesome for me. I want to know John, what your favorite part is, and then you guys wrap it up for us.
Well, I would say my favorite part is, I guess, for somebody who just loves the sport itself, seeing so much talent come through here. And I thought one of the best stories, and maybe you guys would agree with this, the most underrated player in the state last year was Isaac McCoy. And I'm glad Mike Gundy felt the same way at Oklahoma State, because that guy was electrifying. And I'd always run into the recruiting experts and be like, why is no one talking about this kid? He's awesome. And then you see what he did in basketball. He puts up 39 points and beats, the highest rated player for next year. Just amazing player, and seeing a lot more talent like that that compares with anybody out there.
I think my favorite part of it is just, the passion that these fans have. I host a high school scoreboard show on Friday nights after the games on radio, and of course every phone line is just lit up the entire night because people just want to call in and talk. They want to talk about their kids. They want to talk about high school football. That's what makes our world at Vype go around.
Awesome.
Well, I'm kind of expanding on that a little bit, the rivalries.
Yep.
When you take the passion of two fan bases, and there's big stakes on the line. Last year, covering a couple of the Bentonville Harbor games, and they're not real rivals yet, but they're getting there. They're two great teams, and see those big schools, big towns come together like little towns, and then just to drive in to a town on a Friday night when they're playing the rival and see all the windows painted up. You go to the parking lot. Everybody's out there tailgating. It's almost like a college atmosphere at some of these places. It really gets you ready to go cover a game on Friday night when you see that atmosphere.
We like the food at those tailgates.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
If you see the Vype guys coming, just get a to-go plate ready to go.
Don't forget 4029. We'll be there as well. So, gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us. Grant Merrill, Nate Olson of Vype Magazine. We're looking forward to working with you guys in the future. And, John, you stick around because you're going to have to be here as well
right.
in the next segment.
Show off the magazine.
Gentlemen, we'll see you on Friday nights.
Thanks. Thank you. Appreciate it.